Hello and welcome to Sports Vision on WTMB. Joe Palo, Mike Cragen, Bear Cragen, and of course the Chocolate Chicken Palo here as we
Chocolate Chicken Palo.
You know what I'm saying?
Chocolate Chicken's way too much for her.
Yeah, it is.
Hey, speaking of way too much, we got way too much
stuff.
Yeah, we got a lot of stuff to show you. But by the way, happy Thanksgiving to all out there. We're
exactly.
on Thursday night here, the first show. Yeah. Taping it a tad early.
This is, you know, October.
That's right. Two Thanksgiving tournaments we're going to. Go to Cleveland Friday night and Saturday night. We'll show you graphics on that later. And go to Bradley Friday night, Saturday night. There's a boys tournament at Cleveland, girls tournament at Bradley.
Yeah.
Go see them. We got the coaches catching up on. We haven't heard from Coach Williams or Coach Green. Williams and girls basketball at Walker Valley and Green boys basketball, of course, at Cleveland. Punk and Rachel, we told you was coming up. It's coming.
And we got a surprise.
We're going to show you some of the old Thanksgiving people that we know.
So
we're going to make you laugh the last half of the show. So hang in there. Right now, though, to get things started, we're going to hear all about 7 minutes worth of Walker Valley Mustang basketball from Coach Williams right now.
All right, I'm going to talk about the players that we lost last year and what we have to replace this year. We lost two starters from last year's team, LeBron Castlin, our leading scorer, and Zach Martin, our main inside threat. LeBron Castlin's playing basketball in Campbellsville, Kentucky. And Zach is in, I think he's in College of Cleveland State, possibly. It's going to be tough to replace those two. Zach was our leading rebounder, and LeBron, of course, did about everything. He scored for us, got the ball to other people, and just all-around spark plug. This year, we're looking for more people to score and take over that role where LeBron left off. And I think in the long run we'll be better off because we'll have to depend on more people to get the job done. Last year we had a tendency to watch LeBron do his thing, and this year we're going to have to rely on all of us working together and getting the job done. We've got four seniors coming back. We got Brandon Bennett. He's our point guard. That's LeBron's younger brother. Chad Fromm, who started last year, you know, just great all-around player, he gives you everything he's got. Chris Kugler, he started last year until he hurt his ankle, and now he's back to full strength, and hopefully he can have a great year. And Trey Bradshaw, who came off the bench last year, is another senior. We have no juniors in our varsity program, but we have a couple juniors that are new to our program that maybe by midseason or towards the end of the season, they'll be helping us out a little bit. Coming back in our sophomore class, we had freshmen who played varsity last year. Jake Trotter, he's our tallest player, one of our most athletic players, can jump really well, runs, handles the ball, shoots the outside shot well. We're counting on him to take over a lot of the load from LeBron last year. Also, Bryce Sharp, who's played in a lot of varsity games last year, probably played in every one, and it's hard to really describe what he gives, because he gives so much to the basketball team. He does a little bit of everything. He hustles, he plays great defense, he can score, does a great job in the classroom. I just looked at his grade cards, made straight A's again. Just a great all-around student athlete. And also Marcus Jarrett, who played some varsity time last year. He was on the varsity team. And he'll back up Brandon Bennett at point guard and maybe some wing. Jamie Harper is a newcomer to varsity level. He's a great outside shooter. He knows the game very well. Good athlete, plays baseball too. Micah Hawkins will give us some minutes to substitute on the inside. He's about 6'3", another good athlete, really hustles, dives on the floor, gets loose balls, and does little things that really count. And he also plays another sport, he plays soccer. That really helps with his feet. He can move really well. And we have one freshman on our varsity team this year, and he's unbelievable. He's quick. They can shoot the outside shot. He knows the game well. His name is Cody Burrell. He's going to make a name for himself here at Walker Valley in the next 4 years. His older sister played here last year, last 4 years, and Ashton Burrell. She's now at Tennessee Wesleyan. and great family basketball right there. They love the game and they can both play. Okay, our schedule is very tough again this year. You know, AAA basketball in this area is the best, I think. Very difficult. You can be a decent team in other areas, but in AAA, decent is not good enough sometimes. You got to be really good. And with Bradley, Cleveland, McMinn's going to be good again. Ray County's, they'll be fine. And Cumberland County's the only puzzle in the whole district we're not sure about yet, because they got a new school built in that area. We're not sure what players stayed and what left yet. So that's the only puzzle. But the rest of the teams are bringing back players from last year that can really play. I think we'll be competitive. You know, we'll have some ups and downs this year. I think with this group, though, they'll give you everything they got, regardless. And that's all I can ask from, you know, just to give all they got. And they seem to really love to play together, and that really helps out. Our out-of-district schedule is very difficult, too. We've got Red Bank, Baylor, Chattanooga Central, Ultewa, who we saw this past weekend in the scrimmage, and they're loaded again. They'll be tops in their district, and it's very difficult night in and night out. Every night you got to be ready to play. You have no nights off. You know, anybody on your schedule can beat you if you're not ready to play. So the guys are hopefully up for the challenge, and we look forward to it. What's so neat about these guys on my basketball team, they're all from this area. When they graduate from high school, they'll call this their home, this area. And that's what high school basketball is all about, you know, taking kids that come to your high school and making the best of it and going from there. Outside of our regular schedule, we have two tournaments that we're playing in. We're going to Southeast Whitfield and for Thanksgiving, and for Christmas we're going up to Lenoir City. The teams from in the Southeast tournament, they're all from Georgia. I don't know a whole lot about them, but usually they're athletic and most of them can play. And the teams in Lenoir City, McMinn Central's in that, McMinn County's in that, and you know, there's going to be some tough teams in that as well. And I think the Christmas tournament will get us ready for the last stretch after Christmas and hopefully get us ready for February and tournament time. And what's so special for our seniors this year is that they get to stay home for the district and region tournament. We're hosting this year, and we feel very fortunate that we get the opportunity to do this. And hopefully it'll be a great tournament.
What do you do when your cash is low and you need groceries?
You got a cash emergency, you got a money mayday.
Check into cash.
What's check into cash?
It's a remarkable place to get instant emergency cash for flat fee.
We cash your personal check and then we hold it till your payday.
Anytime you have an unexpected expense and need a payday advance, check into cash can make it happen.
Check into cash.
The next time you need quick cash for whatever reason, go to check into cash.
You got a money mayday.
Welcome back to Sports Vision on WTMB and talking about the old days when we were a lot younger.
I'm going to show you a couple of funny things. Stick around, we're punking.
He was smaller.
And we also got some Thanksgiving funnies from way back. You got to take a look at here coming up.
Yeah.
But first of all, we're going to catch up, of course, with a guy who talked with us this morning, Monday morning. Of course, a tragic accident that claimed the life of one of Cleveland's basketball players. Kobe Stansberry, and of course, Coach Green met us this week to talk about the team. Has a little bit of word about Kobe in there. And of course, that team has got motivation and a lot of pride working this year with that situation. And we're going to listen to Coach Green assess the entire team and a little bit about Kobe Stansberry coming up right now for you.
This year is actually going to be an interesting year from the standpoint it's the youngest team I've had since I've been at Cleveland in 7 years. This is my seventh year. And it's also going to be the deepest team that I've ever had. So I think it's a team that from this last couple of weeks of practice and our first couple of games and scrimmages that is going to be really fun to watch. They play hard, and we do have some talent, but it's young talent. So I think you'll see us probably make a lot of errors and as far as execution and stuff like that during games early in the year. And then hopefully, as they gain more experience throughout the year, we'll get better at that. But I think as a coach, all you can ask for is the kids to give good effort. And I think you can make progress when they do that. And, you know, that's the most positive thing right now is we're playing hard and we're making, you know, we're making plays with just effort. Now, we've got a lot of things to improve on. Again, when you have young guards, when I say young, we're playing three freshmen right now, a lot of minutes. And got a lot of sophomores that are playing a lot of minutes. We really don't have a lot of people right now that are that have a lot of varsity experience from the years past. So that's going to be an interesting thing there to see how those guys can adapt and get used to our schedule of the teams that we're going to play in our district. Our district is as tough as always. So as far as our schedule, we've got a tough schedule like we normally have. We've got a Thanksgiving Classic here. Friday and Saturday, our Sky Ridge Medical Center Classic, which will be Friday and Saturday, 6 and 7:30 both nights, the 24th and 25th, Friday and Saturday after Thanksgiving. The first night will be Ray County and Lincoln County boys, and then we'll follow that game up with Cleveland versus East Ridge. And then on Saturday, it'll be flip-flopped. Ray County will be playing East Ridge, and we'll be playing Lincoln County. So over Christmas, we're going to Cookeville to the Mid-South Classic. which Shelville, who is the state runner-up from last year, will be there along with some other Middle Tennessee teams, so it should be a good experience from that standpoint. Like I say, our district is like I said before, is tough as it's been probably since 3 or 4 years ago when you know, when we had a good team, Bradley had a good team, McMinn County had a great team. So it's you know, there's 3 or 4 teams in our district that I think have a chance to be really good. We were picked third by the coaches and the media to finish in the district. You know, which, to be honest with you, I don't know if that's possible. I don't know if we can finish better or worse than that. I think it can go either way. It's still early in the year, and a lot of our young guys, I'm trying to find out what exactly they can do and some of their weaknesses and their strengths. And you know, I think I'll learn more as a coach as we play each game. You know, you can tell a lot in practice and stuff like that, but. It's a different environment when you put the uniform on each night. So should be an exciting year. I mean, we're going to play a style that's fun to watch. We're going to play 10-10 people. We're going to get after you and see what happens. But I really think we're going to be a team that hopefully is going to improve as each game progresses throughout the year. And I think one of our challenges this year, you know, not only right now, is dealing with the loss of Kobe Stansbury. You know, he was our only senior this year. He's been with me as far as when he was in middle school. He was a kind of like a ball boy or manager for me when he was in the 7th and 8th grade. And then, you know, was on the team 3 years. So that's been really, really tough for me as a coach to deal with that. He was it's been well documented the type of person he was. If I went into that, I'd probably leave a lot of stuff out because I don't know if we had enough time to talk about all the good things that he provided not only to our program, to our basketball program, but to our school and our community. He's going to leave a legacy as far as our basketball program is concerned. You know, just what he provided as far as his character, his attitude, his work ethic, and those type of things. And you know, he's one of the finest young men that I've had the opportunity to coach. And will be, you know, extremely missed, not only this year, but for years and years and years to come. He'll be in my mind really as long as I live, and especially staying into coaching. You know, just the type of person he was, and I could keep going on and on about that. But you know, it's affected our players. You know, having to deal with that. You know, the guy that you know that you're changing with each, you know, in the locker room and talking with each day, then all of a sudden he's gone. But you know, that'll be a motivation for us throughout the year. We're going to honor Kobe each game as far as our team, and you know, just try to remember him and honor him as much as we can throughout the year.
All right, and as you said, I think Friday and Saturday coming up, I'm not sure about those dates. I put those in. I think it's 24th, 25th boys basketball. Yeah. Cleveland will play two schools Friday night and Saturday night. They'll play the late game both times. And Bradley, of course, we've been telling you about this one, right. Has their November 24th, 26th. Now, I think they do play all 3 days of the weekend there for girls basketball holiday and tournament. We're taking off to a commercial. We'll be back.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. is better than yours, I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. My milkshake is better than yours. My milkshake is better than yours. My milkshake
milk, better than yours. Shakes. Hand scooped shakes and malts with M&M's. New at Hardee's.
Right, back again. And welcome back with some fun. We got to hurry through these next two things. Some of it's some old nostalgic stuff. But right now, you've seen Budweiser Hot Seat on SportsVision, Sports Center, all of you.
Sports Vision. Now, keep it there.
We put Rachel on Hot Seat. We were given some questions to ask her by Karen Holt. We're going to show you that. We're going to show you what we did to punk her.
Punk.
Real quick, and we'll come back with some more funny stuff. Be right back.
All right, this is just kind of, you know how they do the Hot Seat thing?
Oh, yeah.
So, your favorite movie line?
Favorite movie line? Oh gosh. it would probably be from it would be from Rocky II, but I'm not sure what exactly I would choose.
Your favorite book?
Favorite book, Leading with the Heart by Coach K.
Favorite color?
Red.
Favorite food?
Chocolate chip cookies.
Best basketball program?
Cleveland Lady Raiders.
Favorite way to relax?
Spend time with my family or ride my bicycle. Okay. Well, let me redo that, because bicycle. Spend time with my family or ride my bike.
Okay. Favorite number?
11.
Maddie grows up. As Maddie grows up, she can what?
Always count on her mom being there for her.
Okay. Favorite coach?
Probably Coach Landers.
Former coach you miss the most?
Coach Landers.
Okay. Must do reenactment of Polk County locker room episode with a parent.
Who did that?
I couldn't help myself.
Who did that? Who did that?
Karen.
Karen, I'm gonna kill her. She got me.
She goes, I gotta punk her.
She got me good.
I know you're looking at me like.
Yeah. She just.
The one when I said, favorite food, husband's cooking or Zaxby's. She's got them all written down.
Look, let me see that. That's classic. Karen Hall. Best basketball front, Duke man, that would have been.
She says, let me write some questions so you can ask her after this.
Being the band or being a drama boy.
She took that well.
Rachel Powell Moore, head coach of the girls' basketball team at Cleveland. She got punked and laughed.
Very good girls' basketball team. By the way, just came out. I think they're 5th in the South, Southeast and 12th in the country. Something like that. They're rated real high nationally. So might see some things. Maybe we'll be in Murfreesboro with that big
throw. Now, you know what could happen from this could be retaliation now to Karen.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying?
Oh, look out. Rachel took it well.
But you never know.
Speaking of a little strange, we're going to go back to several years ago. We won't say how long ago.
Second time that I ever would dress as a woman.
Thanksgiving Day funnies coming up from what we did in the past. A couple of skits. We'll see you next week on Sports Vision. We're the only place where you get live highlights to tape. You're going to see them right here again next week.
Have a good one.
This man.
You do.
His name is Bobby.
This is my, well,
that's
how
brother's you, shirt.
That's what I said. That's his brother's shirt, Bobby.
This is my wife, Clement the Kid. You come around here then. I don't like you knowing other men.
I'm sorry.
Now, this is my wife, Clementine, and we've been sent out to find we found Plymouth Rock. We've been sent out to find Dodge or Chevy Rock and wondered if you could help give us directions to that. You know?
You go down here about 2 miles and turn left. And then you go about 2 miles and turn left, and 2 miles and turn left, and the next time you turn left, go 2 miles right there on the corner.
It's on the corner of two, okay.
Those are very good directions, John Benjamin.
I think we can find them.
No problem.
Is there anything that you're thankful for this holiday weekend?
Thankful for?
Yes, sir.
Well, I just had a little trouble. My blood vessels being stopped up, and I'm thankful that we found it in time so I can live a little longer.
Well, Dow Clementine and myself feel the same way, and we are happy that it worked out that way for you, sir.
It's nice to know Jesus, too.
We appreciate that.
See you, bud.
Yes, sir.
Good man right there.
Yes, sir.
Good man.
except for we came over on the Mayflower vessel. He said something about blood vessels. I don't know what he's talking about.
I think that was one of those other ships.
The Pinto.
Pinto and the
Bean.
Yeah.
The Pinto, the Bean, and the Sausage.
Pinto,
Marine.
The Bean, and the Sausage Marine. But the other one he's talking about, was that a vessel that carried all the other vessels?
Are you happy with yourself or what?
What?
Ooh. See that?
Honey, you don't look so good.
I'm feeling a little peaky. Can we rest for just a minute, sweetie? Hookums?
Yeah, hookums. Yes, we'll rest just a minute. I thought you used the trough just a minute ago.
I did. Oh. I think that's from that sourdough bread.
Sit for just a minute.
Just for a second.
Man, you are really
rest.
You're having some problems.
I am really.
Yeah, you're having a lot of problems.
John Benjamin? Benjamin?
Sweetums, I tell you, were you scared there a little bit?
I was very scared.
Now, what have I told you about keeping covered up there? That is unnecessary.
Sorry.
I don't want anyone else to know. It's our privacy at stake there. Okay, rest a minute.
And Faye.
And can you tell us what you're thankful for, Faye? For this Thanksgiving weekend.
I'm thankful for my family, for my church. I'm thankful for a lot of stuff.
And how about this election?
I guess I can be thankful for the media.
For the media.
I don't know.
Would you be thankful to John Benjamin and myself for the wonderful things that we did and are doing and have done from the beginning so we have all this that we have today? Like corn? Turkey?
Yes.
Well, would you
sweet potatoes?
Let's let this lady in here.
Would you?
Would you this please, is Robin.
Robin, would you please hurry up and invent the scraper of the hair, because I'm getting a little tired.
You don't like my hair?
Well, it's a little rough. It's a little rough.
I don't like the way your eyes are looking at all these other women, John Benjamin.
Well, because they
don't have this hair.
I have more modern-looking clothes and much shapelier figures than Val.
What? I don't think so.
Yes. Believe me, Val does have much more.
What's up with that, John Benjamin?
So... Again, and what do you have to be thankful for, Dallas?
I'm thankful for my family and our good health and Cleveland Lady Raiders. Go Raiders.
Cleveland Lady Raiders.
Yeah.
Hello and welcome to Sports Vision, the magazine. I, my friend, am Captain Napkin Neck, and to my left, Big Chief Little Heine. Big Chief Little Heine, welcome to our country. You bear gifts from afar. Corn, I think that's what it is, the yellow stuff that you brought. And we have some things, I hope throughout the show, I can help trade with you some wonderful things we have for some wonderful things you brought.
You'll be fair to Little Heine.
Oh, I'm always fair to Little Heine. The reason being, we're a fair people. And I came over on a Mayflower, you know, and I'm not talking about
a
boat either.
Cousin Chief Little Johnson, he got cheated, he say.
He got cheated?
Yes. I found...
What is that you have here?
I found this, go by the name of Bear. He running Bear through tunnels at underneath building.
Underneath here. Building? You
he
found
now
him.
My running Bear.
Because we haven't been able to find him for a long time.
He mine.
Yeah. All right. Well, you know, I'm just so excited that you've come to, this is a very special thing that I've cooked that we're going to have later on. You and I are going to celebrate our friendship.
How are you cooking these times?
Oh, this is a solar thing. See, what happens is the sun comes in and I'll explain it to you later, but it's kind of a solar heating thing here and the sun helps bake it and it's going to be delicious. You wait till you taste that.
Happy Thanksgiving Turkey Day to you, my friend and white brother.
Thank you very much. You know, thank you. And in fact, thanks for all the gifts you brought, and thanks for just being my friend.
What happened to usually pilgrim wear black?
Oh, hat?
Not pretty like headdress.
Right. When you got hair like this, pal, you don't ever put a hat on it. But in any case, we're going to trade for some wonderful things later on, and we've got this show, and I'm glad you're here with me to help. I keep smelling that. I saw you over there. You look like you got some precious family things over there.
It's real.
Is that real silk?
Genuine silk.
Is it? That is nice.
Steal it off of a silky, one of those four-leg animals.
Oh, a silky.
Yes.
Hey, would you like to trade for this? I'll show you what I have.
No, this is valuable.
Oh, this is very valuable in our country. This is a piece of copper, and copper is worth a lot in our country. It's got a picture of a president that we don't even know about yet on it. What I'm trying to tell you is it's a future piece of copper that's going to be worth so much money, and money is what's valuable, that you're not going to believe it. I will give you this piece of copper for that expensive silk scarf, and trust me, it's worth it.
Someone tell me copper police guy.
Huh?
Copper policeman.
Oh, that's up north. They call him copper. Hey, copper! Yeah, that's a different thing. This is a copper coin.
That good deal.
Yeah, this is very good deal. Keep that and hold that. That'll be. You can buy a piece of gum with that somewhere and buy more of those.
I take good care.
But I'll take this, and this will be. I'll give this to somebody. All right. Trade, because we got some rubies. Good trading. Those are rubies?
Found them in mountains.
Oh, those are nice.
Behind.
Those are worth a lot.
Place of, where we go and. Back there, and these were laying back there.
They were laying back? Yeah. You know, those are a lot of dinero, which is a Spanish thing that we don't even know about yet either, but we'll talk about that.
More copper?
Hey, no more copper, but I got something else very big. This is something I've just created. It's a very expensive, worth a lot, writing instrument. It is wooden writing instrument where you can jot down. It's got a rubber tip and graphite, which we found in the mountains, running through the middle of it.
Let me see.
Wooden writing instrument with graphite and a rubber tip. It is worth a lot. See? And I'll give you that wooden writing instrument for those rubies.
I can draw a picture of moon on cave
you
wall.
You can draw moons, suns.
Princess right there.
I'm sitting here looking at those beads you got there. Those would be nice on that cute little branding princess. I know the guy that she's dating that probably want that. I'll tell you what we'll do. I give you another. I'll tell you, because those are so nice, and I shouldn't be doing this, but I'm thinking about giving you two, count them, two of these copper pieces for those beautiful, expensive pearls. Would you do it? Hey, you got your hand out there. Beautiful. Oh, yeah, it's worth it. Trust me. Two of them. Now you got, what, three? Ooh, man. You're rich.
Go buy me a house.
You're rich.
Okay. Big teepee. Teepee on big right. Mansion teepee.
Right. Or PT.
Mansion teepee that has indoor, outdoor bathroom.
Really? Dude, you're having a lot of problems.
John Benjamin?
Yeah.
John Benjamin?
Sweetums, I tell you, were you scared there?
I was very scared.
Now, what have I told you about keeping covered up there? That is unnecessary.
Sorry.
I don't want anyone else to know. It's our privacy at stake there. Okay, rest a minute.